Hello everybody and welcome to our Tech Tuesday tutorial number 10. Today we're going into a couple of Gmail tricks that you may like. It's the first in a series of Gmail tips that we're going to be sharing throughout the year. We will be covering two features. One is called Undo Send and the other one is called Canned Responses. So let's take a look at Undo Send first. Undo Send is located in the Gmail settings, and basically what it lets you do is delay the sending of an email so that you have a bit of time to undo it. It doesn't actually retrieve that email from the server. It never sends it to begin with. It just delays the sending. It's a nice little trick, but it's particularly helpful if you forget to add on something or you misspell something, or maybe you send an email before you've really thought out the repercussions of that email. So you scroll on down and you just simply check Enable Undo Send and you set the cancellation time. How much time do you want it to delay? You might be tempted to just set it to 30 seconds all the time, but just remember that that does mean that your message will take 30 seconds before it actually sends it out. So that can be an inconvenience sometimes. Once you've specified, remember to scroll down and click Save Changes or it won't save it. The second feature that I would like to highlight today is called Canned Responses, and this is an actual lab. It's still a lab. It hasn't made it into the main settings area, so you'll have to pull down the gear over here, and then when you're at the settings panel, just go up to the top, look at your tabs up there, and choose the labs. The labs are basically experimental things that Google plays with, and some of them graduate and become part of the actual settings for Gmail, but not all of them. Canned Responses is unfortunately still a lab, and it's still pretty rough around the edges. But you'll notice that there's all sorts of labs here that you can choose from to use, and you just simply have to enable them over there. So I've got Canned Responses enabled, and when you enable it, you just hit Save Changes. And what it really does is it basically lets you save snippets that you will like to use quickly and easily, kind of like templates in a way for your email, but they're not full templates in the sense that you can put them in the middle of a full email at any time. They're just snippets of information that you'd like to be able to save. You can even set up rules later so that canned responses are used whenever certain conditions apply. So basically, once you've got that done, you simply go and compose an email. And let's say that I have a typical response I'd like to give out every time I'd like to interview a grad student or something like that. So I can just come in here to a new message and clear it out completely. You want to wipe out your signature because it'll grab that too. You want everything to be as clean as possible before you start your snippet that you would like to save as a canned response. So I'm just going to type that in here, including the subject line. Okay, so this is the basic email that I would like to send, including a link to our appointments calendar that will allow them to see, what's scheduled and be able to schedule appointments there and so on once we put up appointment times and some instructions for them, right? And then the subject line for this, I might want to say, IRC interview offer. And I'm going to leave this part here blank after hello because that's the one part I'm going to go in there and type in their name, right? So I want to save this as a stock kind of thing. I go down to the more options and now I have this option here for canned responses. And here's where it gets to be a little tricky because it's still, like I said, a little rough around the edges. You can insert, save, or delete. And in this case, I already have a canned response for our lab calendar. I want to create a new one. So you have to be a little careful. This is kind of faint and it's a little hard to see. So you have to be a little careful to make sure you don't insert or save over stuff. But you go in here and choose a new canned response. I give it a name, which it pulls from the subject. That's fine. And now it's saved. I can now delete this. And so anytime later in the future when I need to go in there and send this out, I go to Compose. I simply go down to Canned Responses. I choose Insert, not Save or Delete. Insert IRC Interview Offer. It pops that in there. Notice it keeps my signature there. And then I go in there and fix any little bits here. I send it to the appropriate people and I hit send. I can, of course, insert after I've typed some things. I can, further clarify and change anything, of course, and so on. So that's the basics of canned response. If I need to delete it, then I just go in there to canned responses and choose delete. If I need to update it, let's say I need to take out a step or something like that, then I can go in there, canned responses, and then save over the one I already have. Okay, well that's all I have for today. I hope you all enjoyed this. And if you did, make sure you hit that like button. And if you really like what we have to offer every Tuesday and like to keep up with it, hit that subscribe button, and share this video with everybody. I'll see you guys next week. Thank you.